I'm going to play the sound of someone typing. What do you think they are trying to say?
Yeah. We don't know any Shakespeare. We're only monkeys.
So why might we know, just from the sound, what somebody is actually trying to say?
Do they have a slightly different pitch, all of the buttons?
Yeah, so it's the QWERTY keyboard, and it can be translated, if you like, to work out what we are typing.
No.
If you had just a microphone, hackers would be able to discover your logins, your password, any other confidential information that you might be typing, because each key hits a different part of the keyboard's underplate, and there is a slightly different sound for every single one. And there's an algorithm which can be used to work out which sound corresponds with which letter.
Jimmy looks worried.
I'm going to have to learn to write again. Presumably, for each keyboard, it would be different.
Well, we just need 10 minutes with one keyboard with a microphone.
But is this for a typewriter or for a keyboard?
For a computer keyboard. Computer scientists at the University of California in Berkeley estimate hackers would need 10 minutes and they could crack anybody's computer code.
What about an iPad?
I don't think it would work on that, but it would work on a computer.
Do your dirty work on an iPad, Jimmy.
My dirty work.
And now I imagine that dirty work is Jimmy's password.
Boys, because you don't type with two hands like that. Every time I'm on a train, there's some boy typing and he's doing this.
Yeah.
Mavis Deacon did me proud, that little typing thing.
Did you learn to type?
Oh, yeah.
When I was at school, we were all taught to type, and they used to tie an apron to the top of the typewriter and then round your neck, and then so you had to type underneath the apron so you couldn't see.
At the boys' school, Sandy, you're taught to dictate.
Key part of that word is dick.
That was very good. Could you just take that down for us?
We can actually reveal, Alan, what was being typed.
Alan. Say. Blue. Now. All 100 points.
Yeah, it's too late now. A guy called Leroy Anderson, American composer, who wrote the Typewriter Symphony, where the typewriter is used as a percussion instrument. It's one of my favourites. Have a quick look at this video. Isn't that wonderful?
That's a guy that forgot his instrument and refused to back down.
It's a trained percussionist who does it. They slightly cheat. They modify the typewriter so only two keys are working. So otherwise you'd get it jammed, wouldn't you, if you played like that? And I absolutely love it. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Mm.